I would like to thank Fatima Beltran Couture for my designer PPE. In-embroidered talaga nila yung logo ko. As you can see. Thank you, Fatima Beltran, for my outfit for today. More creations, more collaborations to come. Thank you to Fatima and her team for doing a fabulous job with my designer PPE. Thanks, guys. What is my definition of success? I think my definition of success, what true success, because there's worldly success, but my definition of true success would be actually having a harmonious relationship with your own family, being friends with your own sibling, with your own parents. I think that's my true definition of success, because that's difficult to do. Aminin na natin, di ba? Aminin na natin, don't pretend you don't know what I'm talking about, because I know you do. It's difficult. It's easier to be kinder to a total stranger, di ba? Kasi syempre, pakitang tao yun eh. It's easier to be friends with someone you just met than to be friends with your own family. So that's a difficult thing to do. And with the grace of God, I was able to do that, to become friends with my own sister, with my own dad, and my mom. So that's my definition of true success. My greatest achievement would be that I have become best friends with my mom on her last year on earth. My mom is the late great legendary queen of real estate, Miss Jolly Sanchez. She died December 24, 2020, just last Christmas. And I didn't like my mom growing up because she was hard on me because I was panganay. And I didn't like her, especially when I was a teenager. I thought she was this crazy woman because she was undergoing menopause during that time. I was undergoing puberty naman. So I didn't like her growing up. And I thought we didn't have anything in common. Yung pala, we have so much in common. That's why pala I didn't like her. We were both defiant, we're both stubborn, we're both rebellious, we're both determined, I think. We're both very gung-ho and in what we want to do in life. We're both dreamers, we're both visionaries, and we're both activators. And we have so much in common pala. I guess that's why my mom was really encouraging me to follow in her footsteps, because she is the queen of real estate and she wanted to have an heiress to her throne. So in 2008, when I became a broker, we had something in common na. So we always had something to talk about, and he was tormenting me the whole time, and we were able to become friends. And last year, nung lockdown, we were able to become the best friends. So I think that is my greatest achievement, becoming best friends with my own mom. Because it's difficult to do. It's easier to earn like $1 million than to become best friends with your own parents. So I think that is my greatest achievement. So I think I'll always be successful. For me, I'll always be successful because I'm friends with my own family. And I've achieved the greatest achievement, become best friends of my mom. So I always feel successful, and I'll always feel fulfilled. When I got fired from my advertising job in 2007, I was 29 years old, and I hit rock bottom. And so I experienced rock bottom, as in bankrupt, having, you know, being in deep debt, and I didn't know what to do with my life. I'm grateful that that happened at an early age in 2007, because I had 12 years to prepare for this pandemic. So I had 12 years to find out what I really wanted to do, And then when I found out what I wanted to do, which was real estate, I was able to learn the ropes and to be good at it, to be mentored by my mom, the queen of real estate herself. And now I was given the luxury of time, so 12 years, you know, before this pandemic hit. So parang kung hindi ako napalayas nung 2007 at the age of 29, baka last year pa lang ako nawala ng trabaho. So last year pa lang nawala ng trabaho at the age of 43. Tapos my mom pa was sick na at that time, and you know, she died na in December 24. So she wouldn't have been able to pass on the crown if I hadn't been fired at an early age. So buti na lang. So I'm trying to thank my advertising agency for firing me in 2007 at the age of 29. Buti na lang you fired me, because it was a redirection of where I really wanted to be and what I really wanted to do. So I'm grateful for that. So looking back, yeah, it was the greatest tragedy, which became the biggest blessing of my life. Nabuti na lang I was fired na noon pa, so I had 12 years to prepare for this pandemic. So I'm very grateful that I have experienced that. And you know, when you reach rock bottom, there's no other way to go but up. So I'm very grateful for that. So parang when something bad happens to me, like, you know, my mom dying in December 24, you always see na I was think na, of course you don't really think about it right away, na, you know, something good will come out of it. But I think there is hope that, you know, what is meant for your harm will turn into your advantage. And that, you know, everything that will happen to us, all the tragedies that will happen to us, you know, well, eventually could be, you know, it'd be a good topic for a book or for a TED Talk. That's what I'm hopeful for. So, TED Talk, hello. Nagbigay ako ng entry. I submitted an entry. So, pansinin niyo naman ako. To TED Talk. And I think we don't really have to fear the tragedies of life or fear life. Of course, we can just do it afraid. So, thank you everyone. See you next time. Bye-bye.